Hey guys, a couple of bike setup tips. Maybe you could use it. Maybe your bike's already set up this way. Anyway, it's for beginners / novice mountain bikers. Anyway, first little tip is the angle of your brake lever here. So your brake lever should be about 45 degree angled down. This would be straight down, this is straight across, so 45 degree. So if it's too far up, it takes a little more effort and time to get your finger up and around it to pull the brakes. And if it's too far down, if it's angled too far down, when you're going downhill, maybe you're sitting behind your seat on a downhill and you got an obstacle. You're sitting behind your seat. If it's too low, it's going to be a lot harder to grab. Okay. So, also one finger brake setup. That's your tip number two, where I have the brakes set up inside the handlebar a little more. So when I brake, I just have to brake with one finger. One finger for the back brake, one finger for the front brake. And the reason for that is the hydraulic brakes, if you have hydraulic brakes, hydraulic disc brakes, they're a lot more efficient than the older style brakes. So you really don't need two fingers or three fingers to brake. Also, what that does is with one finger braking, it allows you to keep three fingers on the grip. And if you got three fingers on each grip, you'll feel that you'll have a lot more control. And mountain biking is all about control over the bike. Okay. Also, you'll see I have these Ergon grips. And I don't work for Ergon. I don't work for any of these parts that I mentioned in the videos. I don't get anything from them. But have you ever been on a mountain bike ride where after about 4 hours of pounding, your wrists start hurting? Try these out. This is the small size. I'm 5'10". I kind of have smaller hands. But I could have went with large, but the large is a little more weight. I'm a little bit of a weight weenie. But the smalls, they fit my hand perfect. And also, with a little bit of an edge here, you can kind of hold on to them on the side like this for climbing. Also, when you're riding up a hill, this section here, it's kind of bent out a little bit. It's like perfect fit for your thumb. So you can kind of have a wide grip like this instead of just a regular grip. Another tip, a lot of people buy these little foam pieces or rubber pieces to prevent chain slap. Anyway, you can do it yourself by just taking an inner tube, cutting an inner tube into a strip, start wrapping it, and at the very end, just put a tie wrap there. So it's an easy way to make your own little chain slap prevention protection.